Oceans cover 71% of Earth's surface, yet humanity has only explored 5% of these waters. Ocean exploration is an expensive and resource-intense endeavor. A large ship equipped with capable staff can cost tens of thousands of dollars every day. Assembling a fleet large enough to be capable of exploring even 1% more of the ocean is unpractical. Ocean gliders are capable of traveling long distances over extended periods of time with low energy demands, traveling farther, deeper, and for a cheaper price than ever possible before. These crafts can provide critical information predicting weather patterns, tropical disasters, and even environmental changes.
Let's start with GlideX's objectives. As you can see, the list is quite extensive, so we'll start with basics. Number one, a range of 5 nautical miles. 2. Autonomous navigation from A to B and underwater obstacle avoidance. 3. Data exchange with the glider to us and back. 4. A data acquisition system that has limited environmental conditions and internal conditions.
A glider is broken up into 6 subsystems: structural, environmental monitoring, electronic controls, communications, mechanical controls, and propulsions. The structural design of the glider. On the left were 3 designs that were considered in the design phase of the project. The design of the glider was determined using morphological charts.
To better understand the behavior of our glider underwater in a dynamic environment, as well as evaluating the hydrodynamic performance of our structural components, the team conducted 3-dimensional CFD simulations using the speed of ocean currents at desirable operational depths. We were able to collect data for dynamic pressure, pressure coefficient, turbulent kinetic energy, wall shear stress, and the path lines for the velocity profile of water as it flows throughout our glider.
When designing the glider, we used finite element analysis to simulate the water pressure on the glider and ANSYS. We did this by applying a hydrostatic load at 15 meters, our maximum depth, and observing the shear stress, as well as other stresses. This has allowed us to choose materials that could withstand the pressure. The glider was designed with a factor of safety of 4. This means our glider can go 4 times its maximum depth before failure.
Hello, my name is Zachary DeMarco, and I'm going to be explaining the importance of the structural systems of GlideX. The structural system is a crucial part in ensuring that the craft and the instrumentation are safe in an underwater environment. The main hull of GlideX consists of a 3.5 inner, 4.0 outer inch polycarbonate hull tube designed to house the batteries, electronics, and provide a foundation for the structural integrity of the craft. We decided on polycarbonate because of its ability to adapt well underwater and withstand blunt force impacts that may occur. The nose cone is a conical 4-inch diameter 3D printed ABS structure designed to be the forefront of the craft and intake of water for the buoyancy engines. ABS was chosen for its highly water-resistant properties and ability to adequately withstand underwater changes in pressure. For our wing mount and wings, we decided to also go with ABS. The wings are a 10x5-inch NACA 2412 style due to the advantages of lift and drag coefficients and relationships to the angle of attack that GlideX will experience during operation. Lastly, our rudder's details are ABS 3.0 by 3.2-inch streamlined design that is attached to the tail cone vertically, responsible for lateral translations of GlideX. The decision to construct GlideX out of these materials was made based on structural finite analysis simulations and comparisons in yield, stress and strain, and durability of many 3D printable and machinable materials in regards to affordability and suitability for marine environments.
Hello, my name is Mathieu Laplace, and I'm the coordinator for the GlideX team, as well as the subsystem lead for the buoyancy engine. The buoyancy engine is responsible for the forward motion of the craft while being underwater. The buoyancy engine consists of the two following: the ballast tanks, which stores the water inside the craft, and then the overall engine consisting of the stepper motor, which powers the system, the threaded rod, which moves the plunger forward and backwards, and the plunger, which displaces the water inside and outside the craft, as well as being the separation point between the water and the motor components. The buoyancy engine works by displacing water inside the craft by pulling the plunger, which causes a weight change. That weight change will cause the glider to sink. Once reaching a targeting depth and at the specific pitching angle desired, the buoyancy engine will then push the water outside, which will cause the glider to ascend back to surface.
Hello, my name is Charlie Wilson, and I am the electronic controls lead. We utilize an Arduino microprocessor that controls all of our onboard electronics and processes. We also utilize a 9-axis IMU, which monitors the orientation of our craft and allows us to know where we are. We also communicate that with the GPS to track the direction we are going. We also utilize a LIDAR to see the ocean depth as well as any objects in front of us to avoid.
Hello, my name is Mayor Beloach and I'm in charge of the environmental monitoring system for the GlideX platform. Environmental monitoring system is crucial because it allows the team members to be aware of the oceanic conditions. So the three main sensors that we have involved in the system are the pressure transducer, the temperature sensor, and the GPS module. Pressure transducer measures the external pressure at the threaded end, which allows us to determine the depth while in operation. The temperature sensor measures the external temperature by using the probe, and this allows us to determine the temperature of water. Finally, the GPS module allows us to determine the position of the glider, which enables course monitoring and recovery.
Hello, my name is Nick Schuster, and I am the communications lead for the GlideX project. Our glider incorporates two RF transceivers that operate in a 915 megahertz frequency. The main purpose of our transceivers is to gather data from the glider, such as temperature data and GPS data. Another use of our transceivers is to tell the glider when to stop and when to go. This happens at the end of each cycle. The glider will look for a signal from the user that tells it what to do. If it does not receive a signal, it will continue on with its mission.
Hello, I'm David Woodruff, Group Leader of GlideX, Sub-Team Lead of Electrical, and I headed fabrication integration of our glider. Let's talk about mechanical controls. There are two major mechanical control systems in our glider, the rudder and the buoyancy engine. The rudder runs off 220 kilogram servos, which have a mechanical advantage of 1.47, meaning we have about 30 kilograms of torque to overcome the seal's dynamic pressure of the water moving past our glider. The buoyancy engine runs on a NEMA 17 non-captive stepper motor. That means the rod can move through the stepper rotor. This allows us to maximize spatial efficiency. It has 44 newton centimeters of torque, allowing us to push water out even under high load. Our power system consists of four lithium ion batteries. They have a high power capacity and allow us to run our glider for our intended 5 miles. This assumes we run at our 30 centimeter per second goal, and we have no more than 10% losses on top of our expected losses, such as a 92% efficiency on our power conversion from the 14.6 volts of these batteries to the 5 volts our system runs on. As you can see, the batteries are well nested in the bottom of our electronics bay. Not only does this enable our power density to peak, but also makes it convenient for servicing and makes our system modular.
During component testing of the glider, we face significant challenges. Most gliders use prefabricated plunger assemblies, which are inefficient due to the large footprint and low water capacity. We decided to create a completely customized piston assembly with a larger capacity and higher spatial efficiency. This idea was difficult to implement due to the tight tolerances required to make a waterproof seal that is able to slide and not leak under high pressure. However, our stakeholders supported the idea and encouraged us to stick with the design, which took 3 iterations to work better than a syringe-based buoyancy engine. The buoyancy engine is just one example of the creative solutions our group has created. The rudders, waterproof wiring, and seals presented equal challenge. The commercial off-the-shelf solutions for the GPS, IMU, pressure sensor, temperature probe, LIDAR, RF module, and SD writer had their own challenges as well. During final testing, the movable internal weights and adjustable wing mounts made it possible to fine-tune the angle of decline and rise. However, some features, such as the pressure fit nose and tail, needed a more precise method of manufacturing to be able to produce a seal that functioned exactly as intended. Overall, the testing GlideX was very successful. GlideX as a platform offers potential for oceanic discovery, which is easily scalable and bright. Gliders perform best when undergoing large depth changes. The shallow water tested and budget-limited GlideX glider has highlighted the future potential for cost reductions that can make underwater gliders transform from a niche, high-priced system to something that can be implemented in a global scale. Underwater gliders are the future of oceanic discovery.